In this one, we're gonna see how to take the macro to the next level and do some very cool meta programming. The first thing I want to show is how you can stringify the argument of a macro. So it basically, when you do, let's say I would have a macro foo and you would do hello here, it would literally convert hello to a string. And let me show you a quick example. So here I have this macro foo, and it takes an x and a y, and it prints f the actual variable names of x and y, not like x and y, but like the variable names that we or the text we put in the macro when we call it, and then it does the sum of both of them. So let's do this. Let's do let's say 1 plus 2, like so. And you can see it did 1 plus 2, which is not very impressive. But if you do int, let's say first is some number and second is some other number. And here you do first and here you do second, you can see that it will actually do first plus second is this, not the actual value of first and second. And what the way you do this is just by prefixing your variable name by one hashtag in the macro. And what this will do is literally it will replace this by first like this and second like this, and here obviously just first and here just second, and this will be the same thing. Yeah, I forgot the new line, but you get what I mean. Up, same thing. So yeah, that's one way. Yeah, it's pretty handy to print debugging information or yeah, to print more stuff to the user and make your macro more customized. The next thing is, let's comment all of this out, is you can tokenize the argument of a macro. And what I mean by that is it will not interpret it as a value, but as a token, for example, to create a new to dynamically create a new function names. Or a variable name or something. So I have a small example here called prefix. I have a prefix macro that takes a variable name and prefix it with new. And as you can see, I've added two hashtag before the var name. And what you can do, it's relatively strange, but you can do this, is you do, for example, int prefix, and then you do, let's say, foo equal to 3. And so it didn't declare like you cannot do like foo is equal to 3 here because foo doesn't exist. Actually, it created a new variable that is, I mean, it created just a variable that is called new underscore foo. Like so. And as you can see, it works. And it dynamically created a new. It dynamically generated the name of the variable. And of course, you have to have the two hashtag like this because if you do this, like this doesn't work because it doesn't know that this is splitted from the other token. So that's why you have to do it like this. And just alone like this, you might be saying like it's not that useful, but actually you can make generics, kinda like more like manually. You have to manually state which type your generic is capable to handle, but you can still do generic code with this. So here I have a very small example. Let's remove all this. So I have a generic add function, which will create a function that adds two numbers. And here you, instead of passing it a variable, you pass it a type. And what this will do is we will replace the type here, replace the type here. So we know that the function will return the same type as these two arguments. And then we dynamically generate the function name here. So let's say we do, and actually, this kind of macro, you have to do them in the global scope since it will declare a function. So you have to generate add function. And let's say I want a generate add function for the int integer type. And this will generate literally a function like ints. Here, this will be int as well. This will be ints, and this will be int as well. And so, yeah, that's exactly what it will do. And you can see here that if I printf percentage %d and I do add add int 1 2, like so, up it says 3. And then what the cool thing about this is you don't have to write like 3 different add functions for 3 different types. You just do boom 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 up, and here you do float, and here you do, let's say, long, and now you can do float, and then ld, and then let's say big L means it's a long. And as you can see, here it says I'm still using the int one, and here let's say I have floats, and here I do floats, and here I do add long, and boom, it did. I mean, here you cannot really see the difference, but those are long instead of ints, and you can see it generated those three functions. And yeah, with a small function like this, you don't really see the actual quality of life improvement. But if you have a very long function that also needs to be on multiple types, and for example, for a container, like a linked list, or a dynamic array, or a hash table, and so on. And imagine you would just have to do this for a function. Like, this would be really useful instead of repeating yourself multiple times. Of course, the syntax is not great, and I would not recommend using that profusely, but it's very handy and cool to know that you can do that in C. Anyway, that's it, and see you in the next one.